Hello all, welcome to the YouTube live session on Conics section. So this class will be focused on ellipse, the advanced level concepts, the JEE main and JEE advanced level concepts. So those who have joined in the session, I'll request you all to type in your names in the chat box. So guys, I'm going to start this session with a quick recap on the standard form of the equation of the ellipse. So these are the two standard forms that we normally deal with. Okay, so these are the two standard forms of the ellipse. So when I say standard forms, means those ellipses whose center is at origin and whose major and the minor axes are aligned along the x or the y axes. Okay, so just a quick recap of the standard form of an ellipse. So we deal with two types of standard form. One is x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1, where a is greater than b, right? As you can see, a is greater than b. And the other one is where b is greater than a. And the other one is where b is greater than a. The difference in these two ellipses is basically in their orientation. If you look at this kind of an ellipse, it is basically an ellipse which is of this nature. Okay, so its major axis is along the x-axis and the minor axis is along the y-axis. Okay, and this kind of ellipse is where your orientation of the ellipse is in such a way that your major axis is along the y-axis and your minor axis is along the x-axis. So this is your y and this is your x. Okay. So this is a dash, b b dash, a dash, b b dash. So a few things about both the ellipses that we need to keep in our mind. First, the center for both the ellipses is origin 0, 0. The vertices a and a dash is called the vertices. So for this ellipse, let me call this ellipse of type 1. Or standard form 1, and this is standard form 2. For standard form 1, the vertices are at a plus minus a comma 0, whereas for standard form 2, it is at 0 comma plus minus b. The length of the major axis, or you can say the length of the semi-major axis, is going to be a in this case, whereas the length of the semi-major axis in case of the type 2 standard form is b. Okay, foci for this is, remember, foci is always located on the major axis. It's always located on the major axis. It's always on the major axis. Okay. Yeah. So the major axis contains the foci. It contains the vertices and of course the center. So for the type 1 ellipse, the foci is at plus minus a, comma 0. For type 2 ellipse, it is 0, comma plus minus b. The equation of the directrices, as you know, directrices, these are the two directrices. So it's x equal to a by e and x equal to minus a by e. And for the other one, it's like this. So it's y is equal to b by e and y equal to minus b by e. Just remember the change in the expression for the eccentricity. For the first one, the eccentricity is given by e is under root 1 minus b square by a square. Whereas for the second one, it is given by e is equal to under root 1 minus a square by b square. However, irrespective of whichever case you are taking, eccentricity will always be 1 minus the semi-minor axis square by semi-major axis the square, always. So this is a universal formula which you can apply to any type of ellipse, right? Hope there is no question concern with respect to the very basic fundamentals of ellipse which you have already learned in your class 11th. Is that fine, guys? Any question, please type it in your chat box. Meanwhile, I can see 8 people are attending this session. Who are the other three? Please type in your names in the chat box. All right. So moving ahead to the next page, length of the lattice rectum for the case where you have the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1, where your a is greater than b. And for the other case where you have x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1, where your b is greater than a, the length of the lattice rectum will change. So for this one, it is 2b square by a square. Sorry, 2b square by a, and this is 2a square by b. Just remember the coordinates of the endpoint of the lattice rectums. It's actually lattice recta. Okay. It's plus minus a, comma plus minus b square by a. And in this case, it is plus minus a square by b, comma plus minus b. These are the parametric representation for ellipse. So you can write an ellipse as x equal to a cos phi, y is equal to b sin phi for both these cases. Focal radii. Focal radii means the distance of any point from the focus. SP is equal to a minus ex1, and from the other focus, it is going to be a plus ex1. Similarly, for the one where b is greater than a, that is the second type of standard case, it is b minus ey1 equal to b plus ey1. Remember that in either of the two cases, SP plus S dash P will be equal to the length of the major axis. It will be the length of the major axis. That's actually another locus definition of an ellipse. That's what has been written over here, 2a and 2b. Distance between the foci, distance between the directrices is quite obvious. Tangents at the vertices is also quite obvious. Okay. So no questions so far. So I'll start today's session directly with the definition of a locus, which you have already learned. So the locus definition, ellipse definition. So ellipse is defined as the locus of a point which moves in a plane. It's the locus of a point which moves in a plane. Such that the ratio of its distance, from a fixed point, that we call it as the focus, to that from a fixed line, that we call as the directrix, is a constant that we call as the eccentricity, written by E, where the value of E has to be somewhere between 0 and 1. Okay. So on basis of this definition, I'm going to start up with a simple problem question. Find the equation of an ellipse. Find the equation of an ellipse whose focus is minus 1 comma 1, eccentricity is half, and directrix equation is x minus y plus 3 equal to 0. So this question is based on your locus definition that we studied over here. So please feel free to solve this and type in your response in the chat box. So those who are attending the session, request you all to type in your names in the chat box. Guys, which exam do you have tomorrow? So guys, here we have to use the definition that any point P is distance from the focus S. Let's say I call this focus S as a point S. Okay. So SP by PM is always equal to E. That is, SP square is E square PM square. Okay. So SP square is going to be the distance from the focus square of any point x comma y. So that's going to be x plus 1 the whole square, y minus 1 the whole square is equal to e square. E square is 1/4. PM square is basically the distance of the point from the line x minus y plus 3 equal to 0, which is going to be this. Okay. So if you just simplify this, it's going to be 8 times x plus 1 whole square y minus 1 the whole square is equal to x square plus y square minus 2xy minus 6y plus 6x. And if you further open up over here, you get 8 times x square plus y square plus 2x minus 2y plus 2. Okay. So further simplifying this, you get 7x square, 7y square. You get 10x, you get plus 2xy, you get minus 10y, you get... there's a 9 missing out over here. So I'll just write a 9 over here as well. So plus 7 equal to 0. So this is going to be your answer for this question. So guys, let me ask you another basic question before we move on. Find center coordinates of center foci. Let's say an equation of the directrices. Equation of the directrices for this ellipse. Again, I'm sure you have learned about this as well. This is the case of general form of an ellipse whose center is not at origin, but however, the major and the minor axes are still parallel to the x and the y axes. So we had done a lot of problems last year based on this. So just a quick recap of this through a problem. Find the center, foci and equation of the directrices for this ellipse. In fact, you also find out the length of the lattice rectum. And please feel free to type in your response in the chat box. Done? Any response for the lattice rectum length? All right, so in the interest of time, I'll quickly solve this. So first of all, we take the x terms together. We take the y terms together. Okay. Take 4 common, it becomes x square minus 2x. Take 9 common, it becomes y square minus 4y plus 4 equal to 0, which becomes 4 times x minus 1 the whole square minus 1, 9 times y minus 2 square minus 4. Plus 4 equal to 0. So it's 4 times x minus 1 the whole square plus 9 times y minus 2 the whole square. And we have a minus 4 minus 36. So 36 can be brought on here. So divide throughout with 36. You are going to get this equation for the ellipse. Correct? Now, since this is your a square, this is your b square. Since your a is greater than b, please recall the standard form where a is greater than b. Right? So where is, what is the length of the lattice rectum first of all? Length of the lattice rectum for this case will be 2b square by a. So that's going to be 2 times b square, which is 4, by a, which is going to be 3. So length of the lattice rectum is 8. By 3. Okay. Center is, you say x is 0, y is 0. That means the role of x. Now see guys, here we have to do a role change. The role of x is now being played by x minus 1, and the role of y is now being played by y minus 2. So when you say x equal to 0 and y equal to 0, it means x minus 1 is equal to 0 and y minus 2 equal to 0, which implies x is 1 and y is 2. That means the center is at 1 comma 2. Okay. Next is the foci. Before foci, we have to find the eccentricity. Eccentricity is 1 minus b square by a square in this case. So that's under root of 1 minus 4 by 9, which is root 5 over 3. Okay. Foci. Foci for such cases, x equal to plus minus AE and y is equal to 0. Right. So x equal to plus minus AE. AE is this term and y is equal to 0 is this term, which means it can be 1 plus root 5. And it can be 1 minus root 5 and y equal to 2. So the two foci possible in this case is, the two foci possible in this case is 1 plus root 5 comma 2 and 1 minus root 5 comma 2. Okay. What next we want? We want the equation of the directrices. Equation of the directrices is x equal to plus minus a by e. So x is equal to plus minus a, which is going to be 3 by e. So it becomes 9 by root 5. So you can say x equal to 1 plus 9 by root 5 and x equal to 1 minus 9 by root 5. These are your directrices. These are your directrices. Okay. So guys, simple.